So you just got your professional Ambisonics microphone and you want to get started tracking and recording with it as soon as possible. In this two-part video, I'm gonna show you how you can do it in every single DAW available. My name is Alejandro and we are the Audio Brewers. Every single Ambisonics microphone has multiple capsules, which you have to record in a specific order. For this, every manufacturer has created their own color codes so that you can guide yourself on how to connect these microphones. You will see that the connectors have multiple XLRs, and each XLR has color, and each color corresponds to a number. You have to respect these numbers, and you have to record them in order. Always connect them in order. 1 to 1, 2 to 2, 3 to 3, and 4 to 4. Always connect all your capsules to your same sound device. Because some sound devices will add color to your sound, you might want to get the same color in all your capsules, otherwise you might get a different representation of your three-dimensional sound field. So stick to one sound device, always use the same sound device, and if by any chance your sound device only has two inputs or you don't have enough inputs, just make sure the extra sound device that you use is the same brand and the same model that your other sound device. That way, you're gonna get the same color, the same gain, and the same frequency response in each of your capsules. Because all these capsules will interact with each other to create your three-dimensional sound field, you have to make sure that you record them using the same gain settings. Some sound devices will allow you to link your gains to one knob, and this will be ideal so that you can always make sure that they're linked. Some other digital devices will allow you to input the gain using the keyboard. And if you're using analog devices, you're gonna have to use your eyes to just try and match as close as possible the gain of each potentiometer of your input device. Just make sure you always use the same gain. You will notice that every manufacturer will show you where the front of the microphone is by either adding the logo of the manufacturer on the microphone itself or by adding a visual cue. It is very important that you know how this microphone was positioned whenever you were recording. And there are three ways I recommend you positioning the microphone to record your sound. Either looking at your sound with the visual cue looking at whatever you are recording. If you are going to be using the microphone upside down, again, the visual cue should be looking at whatever you are recording. Or if you're going to be using the microphone in a horizontal manner, you should always have the visual cue looking downwards with whatever you are recording in front of the microphone. It's important that you keep note on how the microphone was positioned whenever you were recording. I always recommend, if you are recording in the field, that you tell in a recording how the microphone was placed, or that you take a picture of the microphone whenever the session started so that you know how the microphone was positioned the moment of recording. And that is how you get your microphone ready to record. Now, depending on the DAW you're gonna be using, you can follow the link in the description below so that you can get to the second and final part of this video. Thanks for watching.